We are continuing our discussion of part test 5 for repeaters. Look at question number 54. Calcium oxalate, this is CaC2O4. How many grams of CaC2O4 will be dissolved in distilled water to make 1 liter saturated solution of it? KSP is given, so it's nothing. For calcium oxalate, the relation is KSP equal to x square. Alright, KSP is equal to x square. And x equal to root Ksp, just find out x, that is solubility in moles per liter. If it is multiplied by molar mass, 128 calcium oxalate, you will get the quantity of calcium oxalate which must be dissolved in 1 liter solution, 1 liter water. Look at question number 52. At 20 degrees Celsius, Ag positive concentration in a saturated solution of silver chromate is this much. Alright, in silver chromate, the concentration of Ag positive is this much. Ksp we have to calculate. So, and this is 2x. The value of 2x is given basically. 1.5 into 10 to the power, it was given 1.5 into 10 raised to the power minus 4, which can be written 15 into 10 raised to the power minus 5. So, the chromate ion concentration must be half of this concentration because we are getting 2 Ag positive and 1 chromate ion. So, whatever is the concentration of Ag positive, chromate ion concentration is half. So, just calculate it, you get this value 1.678 into 10 raised to the power minus 12. This is the KSP value. Question number 55. Look at question number 56. The solubility product of AgCl is given. Solubility in 0.04 molar CaCl2. So I told you solubility in the presence of common ion. AgCl ionized to give Ag positive and Cl negative, that is Ag positive concentration is x, Cl negative is x, and in the presence of CCI, this x is ignored. This x is much less than CCI, so this x is ignored. So now we are left with Ksp is equal to x into CCI, or Ksp upon CCI equal to solubility. Now, the one more point is calcium chloride ionized to produce, this is the concentration of calcium chloride, 0.04 molar, and chloride ion concentration is 0.08. So, just put the value of chloride ion concentration, this is Ksp upon chloride ion concentration, you get this value. Question number 56, 5 into 10 raised to the power minus 9, there is a problem. We don't have this option right now. What I am having, by the time your exam occurs, I'll try to change the these values. This is 5 into 10 raised to the power minus 9. All right. Question number 56. Question number 57. Look at question number 57. Ksp of ZnOH whole twice is given. All right. Its solubility in the solution having pH 12. pH is 12 means POH is 2. POH is 2 means OH negative concentration is 10 raised to the power minus 2. See. So again, OH negative concentration is extra. So this X is ignored again. So we are left with the Ksp upon CCI the square, because this 2 is there. And this is the common ion, so Ksp upon CCI the square. So what is the pH value is 12. So H positive is 10 raised to the power minus 12, or OH negative is 10 raised to the power minus 2. So CCI is 10 raised to the power minus 2. The square is 10 raised to the power minus 4. Ksp value is given. We can calculate this new solubility. Alright, look at question number 58. Question number 58. 0.1 molar acetic acid solution is titrated by NaOH. Alright, the question is what would be the difference in pH between 1/4 and 3/4 stage of neutralization? Means acetic acid is given in a beaker and we are adding NaOH to that solution. Alright, and we have to find out the pH when 1/4 acetic acid is neutralized. You have to find out pH first, and then when 3/4 of NaOH is added, means 3/4 of acetic acid is neutralized, at that time also you have to find out pH, and then you have to calculate the difference. So it's a lengthy question. Anyway, suppose this concentration is given 0.1, this is V suppose, alright, so 0.1 V, and we are adding 1/4 neutralization, so it is 0.1, concentration is 0.1, plus volume is 1/4, alright, 1/4 of volume is added. So obviously this is 0.1 V by 4, 0.1 V by 4. Alright, and 0.1 V by 4, 0.1 V by 4 is neutralized. So initially we were having 0.1 V milliequivalent of acetic acid, 0.1 V by 4 NaOH is added, which will neutralize 0.1 V by 4 of acetic acid. So 0.1 V minus 0.1 V by 4, we are left with 0.3 V by 4. We are left with 0.3 V by 4. And obviously sodium acetate formed is same. This is 0.1 V by 4. Means this much is neutralized. So this is converted to salt. So now in the solution we have acetic acid and sodium acetate, means a weak acid and its salt with a strong base. So this is acidic buffer solution. So for acidic buffer solution, this is the formula. And pKa log of, this is the salt concentration 0.1 V by 4 and this is 0.3 V by 4. So we are left with 4 is cancelled, alright. So we are left with this pH equal to pKa log of 1 by 3. Alright, now when it is 3/4 is neutralized, so NaOH added is now 0.3 V by 4. So 0.1 V minus 0.3 V by 4, that is equal to, we are left with 0.1 V. This is 0.1 V by 4. 0.1 V by 4. Alright. So this is, NaOH is completely neutralized. NaOH we don't have in the solution. So we are having as sodium acetate, which is equal to NaOH, which is added 0.3 V by 4. And this is acetic acid left is 0.1 by 1 V by 4. So again we have to put the value. So it is salt 0.3 V by 4 upon acid 0.1 V by 4. We are left with 0.3 by 1 or 3 by 1. So initially it was log 3 and now it is minus log of 1 by 3. this is final pH, alright, and initial pH was log of 1 by 3. So you can say this is log of 1 is 0 minus log of 3 minus minus plus log of 3, or you can say 2 log 3, alright. Point is clear, minus log of 3, minus minus it becomes plus, so 2 into log 3, alright. So correct answer is 4th option. Question number 5-9. Look at question number 5-9. MOH whole X KSP value is given. MOH whole X KSP value is given and solubility is given. Value of X we have to find out. So these are all mathematical things. Otherwise there is nothing. Alright, let us see. MOH ionized to give MX positive and X of OH negative, and this is 10⁻³, alright, and this is X into 10⁻³, and this is again MX positive, we have put the value, and X into 10⁻³ to the power X, or it can be written X separated X square. Alright, and KSP value is 4 into 10⁻, it was 4 into 10⁻⁹, divided by, we have taken this here, 10⁻³, so we are left with 4 into 10⁻⁶ now. Alright, means it was initially 4 into 10⁻⁹ divided by 10⁻, equal to, we are left with this thing, that is x square into 10⁻³ to the power x, x to the power x, I'm sorry, x to the power x. So this was x to the power x, it should be x to the power x. Alright. So we have to find out the value of x. Obviously it is 2. So 2 the square, it is 4, and 10 raised to power minus 3 the square equal to 10 raised to power minus 6. So x is equal to 2. Okay, question number 6, 0. Question number 6, 0. Let us see. What is the minimum pH required to prevent the precipitation of ZnS in a solution which contains 0.01 molar ZnCl2 and saturated with 0.1 molar H2S? Ksp of ZnS is given, and Ka1 into Ka2, this value is given, it is 10 raised to power minus 20. Alright, we have to find out pH. So let us see. Ksp equal to Zn2 positive into S2 negative concentration. Ksp is given, 10 raised to power minus 21. Zinc chloride solution is given, so it will provide Zn2 positive, same, that 10 raised to power minus 2. Alright. So from here we can calculate S2 negative concentration. So it is coming out to be 10 raised to power minus 19. Now K1 into K2 is given by H positive the square into S2 negative upon H2S. Now K1 K2 product is already given in the question. It is 10 raised to power minus 20. Concentration of H2S is given, 10 raised to power minus 1. S2 negative just we have calculated, 10 raised to power minus 19. Now see, it goes here, 10 raised to power minus 21. Alright, minus 21 divided by 10 raised to power minus 19, we are left with 10 raised to power minus 2. That is equal to H positive the square, or H positive equal to 10 raised to power minus 1, pH becomes 1. So again, in this question, we don't have the correct answer. So here also, we will not find any answer, pH equal to 1. So I'll try to, by the time your exam, I'll try to change it. Alright, so pH is 1. Okay, now look at question number 61. All right, we will discuss the next part.